Hello, Grumpy Old Fart here. I'm doing a family game night video of an AD&D, I want to say a story, but it's not really stories. It's more of a phenomena, I guess. pub crawlers. For those of you who don't know what a pub crawler is, it's a person who hangs out in a bar, tavern crawler, a tavern patron, as it were. And invariably, in most role-playing games, taverns, saloons, bars, whatever, that's where the players will end up. Why? There's a good reason. In many role-playing games, taverns are the center of all action in a town. You can go in the Old West, they had saloons. In medieval sword and sorcery, they had taverns and inns. In modern era games, there's clubs, bars, pubs, whatever. But in any game you're playing, whatever the era, people like to congregate where they can socialize. And where do people socialize? Taverns, clubs, bars. And there's some advantages to that. There's a reason for it. It's not, you don't just go there to get drunk in a game. You go there for a reason. In Advanced Dungeons & Dragons, taverns and inns are one of the very first places travelers go when they enter a town or a city. And there's a reason for that. They get rooms to stay in. There's stables for the horses and other animals and things. They get food and drink. They can hear information and get rumors from the locals about possibly if they're on a mission, they can stop in and listen for some local lore. If they're between jobs, they can stop in there and get job offers. And plus, we have socializing. One of the things about Dungeons & Dragons is I don't care what game you're in. I don't care who you're playing with. At some point, if you're playing with your friends, one of your friends likes to get laid. There's no nice way to say that. And in a game, he's going to try to do that no matter what. And bars allow that to happen. He can go off and do his thing with the lovely little tavern wench or whatever her name is, whoever she is. You know, he's off doing his thing. And the rest of the party can concentrate on the job offers and listening for information or whatever, you know. Now, there's a problem with that, as happens in modern bars as well. There are typical problems that come when you enter a tavern. As a dungeon master, taverns are brilliant because thieves can try to rob the players. Players come away from a mission with tons of gold and, you know, with falling out of their pockets or whatever, and thieves are like, that kind of thing. It's a great way to keep players from getting too wealthy, you know, because if a player becomes uber rich, what's the point in adventuring? You see what I'm saying? So you have to kind of keep them poor from time to time. I played in a game one time, just here recently, as a matter of fact. We were jumping from point A to point B on these pedestals, and below was acid. You know, we were getting in the course of the dungeon crawl, and we slipped and fell in, and we lost just virtually everything. Yeah, we was broke. We had no gear. We had nothing. It's ridiculous. And that's a great way for the game master to create a little side adventure where they have to find more money and get more gear and blah, 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 blah. It creates more role-playing opportunities. So it's not just to be mean to the characters. It's, you know, it's part of the game. And plus, if your character has all that he needs, what's the point in adventuring? Like I said before. In a bar, a lot of times you run into people you know and don't like. Foes, foemen, foe women, foe monsters, foes in general. And of course, they will try to kill you. And you've got to watch out for that kind of thing. It may be somebody you don't know that's been hired to try to kill you by somebody you don't like or that doesn't like you. I mean, the possibilities for conflict in a bar of a deadly variety, of serious, you know, variety, are endless. Anytime you're on an adventure, somebody somewhere wants you to fail that adventure, even if it's the bad guy, and he'll send assassins to try to kill you at the tavern. It's happened before, it'll happen again. The other part of this, and this is notorious in taverns, in Dungeons and Dragons, the obligatory bar fight over nothing or anything, or you never know. A tavern fight will start, and of course the players have to get in there and get their licks, and somebody will get their butt whooped, and blah 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 blah. Somebody gets dragged out the back by their buddy as the guards are coming in the front. I just, you know, it's always something, and it's all fun. Anytime there's a tavern involved in a game, it's always fun. Lately, in the last decade or so, players that I play with have gotten smart, and they'll go in, get the room, go right up to the room, take, you know, buy ale or whatever, and take it up to the room and stay there. Avoid all that stuff. But that's okay, because that's where the thieves can break into the room, through the window, or, you know, pick the lock on the door, whatever. You know, there's ways. A crafty DM can always find ways to relieve players of their hard-earned gold. But taverns are awesome. They really are. They're the center of most towns socializing, because they didn't have no TV. And what else is there to do but sit around and pound down a few ales and dance with the barmaid and listen to some minstrels play the music? It's all there. But in game terms, taverns are the place to be. You folks have a good day. God bless one and all.